Toni Stone is a woman that was born in West Virginia, moved here with her family when she was around 9 or 10 years old. Toni was a young lady that was a great athlete, and at her time, women weren't really included in athletics. And she had a love for all of the sports, but her main love was baseball.
The first thing I noticed about Toni is she had the body of an athlete. She was an interesting woman. I've loved many of the women that I've done biographies and things of, but Toni was special, not just because of what she'd done, but because she was so very much herself.
At some point in time, her parents really didn't want her to play, but she was befriended, mentored, encouraged by Father Charles Keith from St. Peter Claver Church. Father Keith got her involved with a boys' baseball team, and then from there it kind of took off. She was an outstanding player as a woman, and her first probably known team that she played with here was the Twin City Colored Giants.
20 years ago, I was in charge of municipal athletics, and what our project was at that time, because Toni Stone was going to be honored in some way, and we had to find a facility that made sense for Toni Stone to be honored too. And this was the facility because she lived down the block, went to St. Peter Claver, which is, you know, about 4 or 5 blocks down. So we decided that this would be the appropriate field to dedicate to Toni Stone.
Toni said, "Women never quite knew what to do with me." And there was a little sadness about that.
Toni kind of leaned on herself a lot, you know, and what she wanted. When she was a child, you know, just the thing of playing baseball, that's what she loved to do. That was her priority all the way from the beginning. And of course, her parents didn't think that that was job related, baseball. You know, they wanted her to get a job, do different things in life, but baseball is what she chose to do. And she really fought for it by herself.
First of all, at that time, you know, she was a woman. And you just didn't play in boys or male sports. So that struggle by itself was one. And when she did play, you know, she kept getting overlooked. There are many stories when she made it into the Negro Leagues where men would say, you know, you need to be in the kitchen and all of that kind of stuff and not playing. And some of the fear from some of the men in those situations was they were potentially going to lose their job. If she played well. So being the first woman, again, she encountered a number of situations where being compared to a man, how good was she really, but she could really play.
Toni was a fun person. She was a really go-getter. And it was so funny because the way I grew up with Toni, I didn't grow up with baseball. She wasn't a star to me. She was my aunt. Toni would want to be remembered as the first female baseball player, professional baseball player, and the fact that she'd given other people, other female players, something to strive for, something to look forward to. And she'd rather than anything else be remembered of the person that played baseball, because baseball was her love, you know, and she got through it. She triumphed through it.
I know I can go on too long, but I loved her. We loved her, our family loved her, and that's why I personally have never written about her, because I had too much respect for her.
The struggles were many, but her persistence, her perseverance was very strong because she loved and wanted to play baseball. And I think that's a tremendous tribute to her to overcome so many different barriers.